Hello everybody, welcome to this next video. Here we will talk about basis and dimension of a vector space. So let us see what we are actually doing. So you have a vector space V, and this is most of the times infinite, like it has infinite elements, right? Okay, and because in our course we are dealing with only the real vector spaces, and so it means that our field is R. So our vector spaces are having infinite elements, right? Now, to deal with infinite elements is a difficult task. So we are looking for a smaller set, right? We are looking for a smaller set which can, you know, represent whole of your vector space. We are looking for a smaller set which somehow represents whole of V. Right, now you will say that, madam, we have already done this thing, where we have already done this thing when we searched for a subset S of V such that span of S is equal to V. Okay, so this is span of S. I would like to say some of the people, they use this notation for span of S. Okay, so don't be confused, they are both the same thing, right? Is equal to V. So we have already a smaller set, we already have a smaller set S, right, where span of S is equal to V. So what we are looking for here? So out of these smaller sets, we are looking for the smallest set. So you see, what you have done earlier, that you had a vector space V and you had found out that there are so many sets S1, S2, S3. There are so many sets which can, you know, span V. So you have S1 span is equal to V, right? And you have S2 span is equal to V, right? And so on. Now, out of all these S1, S2, S3, you are looking for the smallest set. You are looking for smallest set. Okay, and this search for smallest set leads to something called basis of a vector space. It turns out that if the set is linearly independent, then that is going to be the smallest set. So we will have a definition for basis of a vector space. Basis of a vector space. Let me write down the formal definition. Let V be a vector space. A subset D is said to be basis of V if the two conditions are satisfied. If the following two conditions are satisfied. The first condition is that your set B should be the linearly independent set. You know, this will lead to that fact that this is the smallest set. B is a linearly independent set. Now, what is a linearly independent set? This I have explained in the previous video. And the second thing is that span of B should be equal to whole set V. Okay, span of B should be whole vector space, not subspace, V. So these are the two conditions. If these two conditions are satisfied, then we say that B is a basis of vector space V. We will look at some examples. So you look at this example 1. We have here, let V3 be a vector space, which is, we already know this is a vector space. This looks like x1, x2, x3, where x1, x2, x3 are real numbers. Right? We know that this is a vector space over the field of real numbers. Okay, let this be a vector space and consider a set B is equal to 1, 0, 0. This is your I cap vector. If you think about vectors in 3D, then you have 0, 1, 0. This is your J cap vector. Then you have 0, 0, 1. This is your K cap vector, right? So the question is, check whether B is a basis or not. Basis for V3 or not. Now, this is your question. So, you know the definition of basis, that it should be a linearly independent set, whatever set you are having. And the second is, it should span your whole subspace. Whole space. I'm sorry, I'm calling it subspace. Okay, so let us find out it. We'll see condition 1, whether B satisfies condition 1. There is no, you can make it as first condition, it is second condition, right? So just condition 1 means linearly independent. You are checking whether B is linearly independent or not. For that, you already know that to check whether a given set is a linearly independent set or not, you will multiply the elements with some scalars and you will look for the values of the scalars. So I am taking first element, I am multiplying with alpha, I am taking second element, I am multiplying with beta, and then I am taking the third element and multiplying with gamma. Is equal to 0, 0, 0. So from here you have alpha, beta, gamma is equal to 0, 0, 0. So this implies alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma equal to 0. It means that the only linear combination which makes it equal to 0 is the trivial linear combination. Therefore, it is a linearly independent set. It is a linearly independent set. So first condition is satisfied. Now we will look for the second condition. Second condition says that every element of V3 should be linear combination of the elements of B. Right. So condition 2, or you can see this condition, span of B should be equal to V. This is possible or not. So for that, you will take an arbitrary element of your space. So let x1, x2, x3 be an arbitrary element, be an arbitrary element of V3. Right. So you can write this as x1, x2, x3. I can write it very clearly as x1, 0, 0 plus x0, x2, 0 plus 0, 0, x3. So I can write it as x1 into 1 comma 0 comma 0 plus x2 into 0 comma 1 comma 0 plus x3 into 0 comma 0 comma 1. So you see that every element is linear combination of these three elements, and these three elements are nothing but the elements of your set, given set B, right? So it means that every element of V3 is linear combination of elements 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So it means that span of this set, this is the elements of set B. Therefore, span of B is equal to V. Therefore, both the conditions are satisfied, condition 1 and condition 2, right? V3. V here is V3, right? Okay. So therefore, we can say that 1 comma 0 comma 0 0 comma 1 comma 0 0 comma 0 comma 1 is a basis for V3, right? Okay, now let us look at more examples. So you have another example. This you can do it yourself, that 1 comma 0 0 comma 1 is a basis for V2. V2 is actually R2, where the elements looks like x1 x2, where x1, x2 are reals, right? So I'll give you another example. Okay, here your question is, show that S is equal to 1 comma 1 comma 0, 1 comma 0 comma 1, 0 comma 1 comma 1 is a basis for R3, is a basis for R3, right? Which is, again, I have written x1, x2, x3. Where x1, x2, x3 are real numbers, right? So here again, we will check the two conditions. First, linearly independent. For that, we'll multiply the first element with alpha, second element with beta, and third element with gamma equal to 0, 0, 0. And we will search for the values of alpha, beta, and gamma. You see, you'll get alpha, beta, and 0, gamma. So alpha plus beta as your first component. Then you'll get alpha plus 0, beta plus gamma. So alpha plus gamma as your second component. Then you'll get 0, alpha plus beta plus gamma as your third element component. So you get 0, 0, 0. From here, you get alpha plus beta equal to 0. Alpha plus gamma equal to 0. Beta plus gamma equal to 0. Right? Now you solve it. From here you'll get beta is equal to minus gamma. From here you'll get alpha is equal to minus gamma. And you put the values of alpha and beta, so you'll get minus gamma equal to 0, which says minus 2 gamma equal to 0, which says gamma equal to 0. And then both alpha and beta equal to 0. right? So you get that alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 0. Therefore, the only combination, linear combination possible which makes this equal to 0 is 0, 0, 0. Therefore, this is a linearly independent set. Therefore, B is a linearly independent set. So given set, whatever is the name, S is the name. So S is linearly independent set, right? Okay, fine. Now, let us see the second condition. Second condition is whether S, which is this 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1 spans V3 or not. So it means that you want to see if you take any arbitrary element of V3, can you write as a linear combination of these three elements or not. So let us take arbitrary element in V3 as x1, x2, x3. Right? You want to see whether you can write it as alpha into 1, 1, 0 plus beta into 1, 0, 1 plus gamma into 0, 1, 1. You want to see whether you can do this or not. So you have from here alpha plus beta, alpha plus gamma, alpha beta plus gamma is equal to x1, x2, x3. So you get alpha plus beta is equal to x1, alpha plus gamma is equal to x2, beta plus gamma is equal to x3. Right, from here you get beta is equal to x1 minus alpha. From here you get beta is equal to x3 minus beta. Now you put the values of you can just equate these two. So you will get, not this one, we are not using it right now. So you just equate these two, right? You will get x1 minus alpha is equal to x3 minus beta. From here you will have alpha minus alpha, here you have gamma. Right. So here you have gamma, so you'll get minus alpha plus gamma is equal to x3 minus x1, right? Now you can just add these two, right? Add, you'll get 2 gamma is equal to minus x1 plus 2 gamma is equal to, you just add, you'll get 2 gamma is equal to minus x1 plus x2 plus x3. So your gamma is equal to minus x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 2, right? So you get the gamma here. From here you can get beta, and then you can get beta is your x1 minus alpha. Yeah, fine. Okay, so here you can get the value of beta, and from here you can get the value of alpha. So you can see that alpha will be equal to x1 plus x2 minus x3 by 2, and beta will be equal to x1 minus x2 plus x3 by 2. So it means that given any alpha, beta, given any x1, x2, x3, you can write it as alpha, which is x1 plus x2 plus minus x3 by 2 into first component. First component of the set was 1, 1, 0 plus beta, which is x1 minus x2 plus x3 by 3 into the second component, which is 1, 0, 1. Plus the third gamma, which is minus x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 2 into the third element, which is 0, 1, 1, right? So this is possible. It means that every element of the space V3 is linear combination of these three vectors, right? Therefore, V3 is equal to span of S. Therefore, all the two conditions, that V3 should be equal to span of S and H should be linearly independent, they are satisfied. Therefore, S is a basis for B3. Right. Now, from these, you see what we have done here. You note this thing. In the previous question, we have proved that 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 is a basis for V3. Is a basis for V3. And in this question, we proved that 1, 0, 1, 0, 1 is a basis for V3. So from here we conclude that basis is not unique. In fact, you can find out many bases, right, for V3. Infinite number of bases you can find out for V3, right? So this is one conclusion. And another note is, you see, proving that span of set is equal to V3 is difficult. Not very difficult, but this is the tedious task. proving that a set is linearly independent is relatively easy. So we would like to get rid of the second condition that we will do in the later video. So this you should keep in your mind that we want to get rid of this condition somehow. Okay, fine. And this is how the basis of a vector space V is defined. In the next video, we will study what is the dimension of a vector space. Thank you.